Kemudianlah, ya. Yeah, so before we start, let us begin our session with Ummul Kitab Al-Fatihah. Okay, alright. So your class, yeah, I've been teaching you Building Services 1, yeah, Semester 2. And now again, I'm teaching you BQS 552, which is Construction Technology 4. 552 kan? Bukan 560. Betul kan?
Betul.
Okay, alright. So, saya SEM ni banyak ajar semester 4 ya, untuk Project Management 1 dan juga Constec 4. Okay, so 552 adalah Construction Technology 4 ya. Untuk subjek ni, basically untuk hari ni saya tak intend untuk buat lecture lah ya, because minggu yang pertama normally just introduction on the course ya, kemudian what would be the method of assessment, yeah, and apa topics-topics yang you akan belajar, yeah. So normally untuk first week, saya tak buat lecture, yeah, sebab minggu pertama ni student masih lagi apa transitioning between cuti dengan baru start SEM, yeah. So maybe untuk hari ni kita just go through the course outline, course description, yeah. Kemudian next week, then we will start with our first lecture lah. Yeah? So basically today will be a very brief class, yeah, on the course info. Yeah, I will be uploading the course info to the group WhatsApp as well. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah? Okay, boleh nampak ke slide saya share ni? Bukan slide, PDF saya share. Boleh nampak ke?
Boleh.
Okay, alright. So, this is the course description. Yeah, so basically, Construction Technology 4 ni is all about civil engineering construction. Yeah, what you will learn adalah apa? Kerja-kerja construction sebelum bangunan naik. Kiranya bawah-bawah lah ya. Contoh macam earthwork, piling, basement, retaining wall dan juga surface, subsurface water drainage. So basically it is designed to provide you with the knowledge, understanding and skills of civil engineering construction. Yeah, so the topics that will be covered, yeah, you can find it at the right side of the document. Nanti I'll walk through juga, yeah, each of the topic untuk just briefly explain what you should expect out of each topic. Yeah. So for the learning outcome, at the end of the course, you should be able to evaluate, yeah, nombor satu, nombor dua, evaluate and discuss on the general planning, design consideration as well as construction method of the various building elements. Yeah, nah, untuk apa nama ni, standard, yeah, untuk you punya degree level punya standard expectation, yeah, mengikut kepada Bloom taxonomy, untuk pelajar-pelajar undergraduate, yeah, you sepatutnya dah boleh apply, yeah, application of knowledge, yeah. Kalau apa, high school diploma is more on knowledge acquisition, tapi bila dah naik degree level, by right the student should be able to apply, ya, dia lebih kepada application. Maksudnya what you learn in class, you should be able to apply it, ya, knowledge tadi kepada real life scenario, ya. So how to check on your application is through your assignment, ya. So melalui assignment normally, dan juga melalui soalan-soalan test, ya, dia lebih kepada application, ya. So contoh maksud application ni, you will not find soalan as straightforward as explain on piling system, tak, ya, dia lebih kepada application. Contoh kita bagi you scenario, kemudian you have to apply, ya. So again, application will be gauged through your case study, through your assignment, eh? And by the end of this course also, you should be able to demonstrate good presentation skills and teamwork in relation to you presenting your ideas. So again, presentation untuk semester ni, I do not intend to do video presentation. Untuk presentation kita akan buat secara face to face, ya. So minggu yang terakhir sebelum you punya test, kita akan buat presentation, ya. Mengenai presentation dan assignment, saya akan explain lebih during week 3 ataupun next week, ya, paling awal next week, paling lambat week yang ketiga, ya. So these are some of the references that you can refer, ya, for this course. Tapi untuk tujuan nota, apa, belajar nota semua tu, saya akan provide lah, ya. So I'll be providing notes in the WhatsApp group dan juga dalam U Future. Yes. So nanti U Future, hopefully by the end of this week, I will be able to upload all notes and also accompanying videos lah, ya. So the subject is taught through formal lectures, ya. This semester kita akan start dengan 3 kali online classes ataupun 3 minggu online classes. Following your raya break, then only we will have your face-to-face lecture lah, ya. So macam biasalah, pengajaran melalui lecture. Now, one thing that I want to highlight is on the assessment method, ya. So assessment method for Construction Technology 4, ya, because this subject is a fully coursework subject, maksudnya kita tak ada final exam. So your assessment would be based on assignment dan juga test, ya. So assignment yang paling atas ni is 40%, ya, consists of report and also presentation. So daripada 40% ni, 30% would come from your report and 10% would be from your presentation. Yeah, so report daripada case study. Yeah, so what you will do in your assignment is that you will need to buat literature search, yeah, kemudian buat case study. Yeah, say dan masuk kepada case study. Yeah, again, this one dari segi pemilihan tajuk, dari segi apa nama tu, explanation on the assignment, kita akan buat minggu, once the assignment brief is ready. Yeah, hopefully by week 3 lah. Yeah, so that is 40% on the assignment. Assignment secara group, yeah, nanti I'll inform berapa group and how many members per group. Yeah. Kemudian the remaining 60%, yeah, a huge portion of the marks will come from your test. Yeah. So test untuk subjek ni kita ada 2, test 1 dan juga test 2. Yeah. So test 1 selalunya akan dibuat minggu yang ke-7. Dan test 2 akan dibuat minggu yang ke-14, ya. So take note on the date of the test. Test ni dalam lecture schedule pun saya dah highlight, ya, bila akan dibuat. So test 1 minggu 7, test 2 minggu 14, ya. Again, to pass this course you need to score at least 50%. But this being a fully coursework subject, ya, try and score higher, ya. Kalau boleh B plus and above lah. Untuk subjek 552 ni, it's not that hard to score, ya. Especially kalau you boleh jawab test dengan baik. Yeah, selalunya untuk dapat A minus is very easy. Yeah, it's very, it's not hard. Yeah, it's not that hard compared to subject yang ada final exam. Yeah, normally selepas test 1, I will be releasing the marks, yeah, untuk kepada student supaya you can gauge lah berapa you punya performance and you can tambah baik, yeah, untuk test yang kedua. So that is on the marks allocation. Yeah, ada apa-apa soalan sebelum saya pergi kepada lecture schedule? Any question, class?
Okay.
Ada, ya? Dah mengantuk dah you all semua. Pagi tadi ada kelas ke?
Okay.
Sampai kelas pukul 8? Dah start lecture?
Belum lagi.
Belum lagi. Subjek apa tu?
Subjek measurement.
Measurement. Okay. Alright. So, okay. Bear with me. Just kejap lagi. Kita cuma walk through lecture schedule. And then kemudian, you can have your short break, ya, before you punya, I assume you ada kelas petang lagi? Petang ada kelas?
Yeah.
Ada?
Yeah.
Ada, okay. Alright, so untuk kita punya weekly schedule, ya, so minggu yang pertama, again, just introduction, ya, introduction to the course. This will cover the course outline, course requirement, basically what we are doing today lah, ya, intro kepada course sahaja, ya. So minggu kedua dan ketiga, yeah, next week onwards, minggu kedua ketiga, you will be having your first lecture on the topic of earthwork. Yeah, so untuk minggu, untuk topik earthwork ni, dia akan cover basically excavation works. Yeah, dia akan start with kerja-kerja yang paling awal dibuat untuk construction. Yeah, basically earthwork ni is the earliest work that you will do in construction punya stage, ya, dia akan start dengan excavation, ya, kemudian barulah you akan start dengan kerja-kerja yang lainnya. So earthwork, a huge part of the earthwork topics will cover on the importance of earthwork and also excavation works, ya. So excavation ni kita ada banyak jenis lah. Ini saya summarize kan saja. Nanti you will learn in detail once we start with the topic, ya. So excavation, you have the open cut excavation, ya, cut and cover excavation, ya, cut and cover pun kita ada apa jenis bottom up ke top down ke, ya. So what you will learn adalah jenis-jenis excavation, proses dia macam mana. Kalau open cut tu apa yang dimaksudkan dengan open cut? Kalau cut and cover, how do they do it, ya? Top down, bottom up tu macam mana excavation tu dibuat? And you will learn on the pros and cons of each of the excavation technique, ya. Contoh top down apa kelebihan dia, tapi apa kelemahan dia, ya? Dan juga dari segi suitability of the method, ya. Say for example, open cut sesuai untuk excavation site yang macam mana, ya. Cut and cover sesuai untuk construction yang macam mana, ya. So you will learn on the suitability, because remember you need to know how to apply, ya. So kata you belajar on excavation, kemudian you dah tahu suitability dia, ya. So soalan test ke soalan assignment ke akan berkisar kepada macam mana you apply your knowledge, ya. So test will not be as straightforward as explain on the open cut, for example. No, you will be given a scenario, ya, katalah site tu criteria dia macam ni macam ni. So you will have to suggest on what type of excavation, ya. So sebab itu di dalam topik excavation kita akan ajar dari segi suitability, pros and cons, ya, dan juga what you will cover in earthwork will also include the support required during excavation, ya, support system. Contohnya during excavation apa yang perlu di ada tak support yang perlu untuk tanah contohnya, ya. So these are amongst the things that you will learn lah dalam topik earthwork, ya. So kemudian after week 3 you will have your Hari Raya break, ya, minggu 8 sampai 13 April tu. So after that kita akan naik balik ke campus, so dah tak ada online lah. Minggu keempat onwards will be a face to face class, ya. So untuk topik yang kedua adalah on soil improvements and stabilization technique. Now dalam site, tak semestinya tanah yang ada dekat site tu terus sesuai digunakan untuk construction. Sometimes the soil ataupun the condition of the soil on site is not suitable to be used for construction, ya. Contoh dia punya moisture content terlalu tinggi, dia punya density is too high, ya, dia punya plasticity is too high for example, ya. So sebelum tanah tadi boleh digunakan apa, tanah, kalau contoh tanah-tanah jenis yang tak sesuai digunakan untuk construction, before construction work begins, dia kena improvekan dulu condition tanah tadi. Say for example, kalau tanah yang jenis terlalu watery, terlalu lembik, ya, they can add lime for example untuk jadikan tanah tu workable, ya. Kita panggil dia workable, boleh digunakan, boleh digunapakai untuk construction, ya. So that is soil improvement. Kemudian stabilization is untuk menguatkan tanah, ya, because di atas tanah ni kita nak construct bangunan, kita nak construct struktur, jalan etc. So tanah yang di bawah ni perlu kuat, ya, kuat untuk menampung load, ya, kuat untuk menahan forces, ya. So we have to stabilize the soil, ya. So untuk improvekan tanah, untuk stabilizekan tanah ni, there are various techniques that can be used. Teknik yang tradisional sampailah teknik yang modern, ya. So this is basically what you will be learning under the topic of soil improvement and soil stabilization, ya. So kemudian topik yang ketiga adalah on earth retaining structures ataupun retaining wall, ya. Some literature might refer to it as retaining structures, some might call it retaining wall, ya. Ini sebenarnya benda yang sama. So retaining structures are basically structures that are built untuk tahan tanah, ya. Tanah ni kadang-kadang kalau dia dah exceed dia punya angle of repose ataupun safe angle, dia akan ada tendency untuk collapse, ya. So in order to prevent this soil from collapsing, we can build a wall ataupun a structure that we call as retaining wall ataupun retaining structure, ya. Retaining structure ni ada banyak. Dekat apa tepi-tepi jalan pun you dah biasa nampak, I'm sure dekat kawasan perumahan pun ada, ya. Mungkin you cuma you tak notice saja that this is one type of retaining structure, ya. So retaining structures pun, there are various types of retaining structure. Ada yang internally menguatkan tanah secara internal, ada yang menguatkan tanah daripada luar, ya. So you akan tengok dari segi, samalah, dari segi construction, dari segi suitability of the method, ya. So that you can then decide ataupun boleh fikir kalau jenis tanah macam ni, retaining structure yang macam mana yang sesuai, ya. Jenis kawasan macam ni, retaining wall yang mana yang sesuai, ya. So retaining structure, there are various types. We have gravity wall, yang mana wall tu besar, ya. Kemudian kita ada wall yang lebih slender, ya, lebih nipis, cantilever wall, ya. Kemudian we have buttress wall for example, ya. So there are various types of retaining structures. So this is the process dan juga dia punya characteristic of the wall, suitability of the wall. Tu yang you akan belajar dalam topik yang ketiga. So selepas conclude topik 1, 2 dan 3, you will have your test 1. Yeah? So test 1 ni dia akan cover 3 topik yang di atas ni saja. Yeah? Earthwork, soil improvement dan juga retaining structure. Yeah? So semua akan masuk, 3-3 ni akan masuk dalam test 1. Test 1 dalam format essay. Ya, sama ada you kena jawab 3-3 soalan ataupun pilih 2 daripada 3. Ya, again, format test, sebelum you jawab test, I will be briefing you on the format as well. Ya. So after test 1, ya, you akan masuk topik number 4 which is deep foundation. Ya, deep foundation ataupun piling. Dia samalah, ya, deep foundation, piling is the same thing. Ya. Foundation, you can divide them into two. Satu adalah shallow foundation. Yeah, shallow foundation termasuklah rough foundation, pad footing, yang tu shallow foundation. Yeah, shallow foundation ni maksudnya transfer of load daripada bangunan ke tanah tu tidak terlalu jauh, tidak terlalu dalam. Yeah, selalunya shallow foundation ni kalau kata tanah tadi, apa nama tu, dah strong, yeah, dia punya tanah yang bagian foundation tu dah kuat, ya. Yeah, ataupun struktur tadi tidak terlalu besar. Eh? So you can use shallow foundation. Kalau shallow foundation tak sesuai, then you kena gunakan deep foundation ataupun piling. Yeah? So piling ni penggunaan dia depends pada keadaan tanah. Ada tanah yang bahagian atas dia tak stabil. Load transfer kena berlaku jauh di bawah tanah. Yeah? So itu dinamakan deep foundation because the transfer of load happens at a deeper level underneath the ground. Yeah? Or when the structure is too huge, ya, bangunan-bangunan yang berpuluh-puluh tingkat, ya, yang ni selalunya akan menggunakan piling because we need a very strong foundation, ya. So deep foundation, kita akan cerita mengenai jenis-jenis pile, ya, and the importance of piling dan juga what are the methods of piling, ya. Contoh kita ada driven pile, ya, driven ni selalu yang dia ketuk pile tu masuk, ataupun bore pile yang mana dia cast in situ, dia bore lubang dulu kemudian masukkan piling, ya. So this you will learn dalam topik deep foundation, ya. So tentatively after week 9, after topik deep foundation tu, you akan ada mid semester break daripada ujung Mei sampai awal Jun. Come back from the semester break, then kita akan masuk topik yang kelima which is basement construction, ya. So basement, you will notice that some of the part of the topic that you will learn in basement akan bear some resemblance dengan topik earthwork, ya, sebab basement pun kita akan cerita pasal excavation. Basement pun kita akan cerita pasal support for excavation, ya. So sama. Excavation method yang you belajar dalam basement sama je dengan excavation method yang you belajar dalam topik earthwork, ya. Dan dalam basement pun kita akan cerita macam mana cara-cara nak waterproofkan basement, ya. Kenapa nak waterproof? Because basement ni dia duduk bawah tanah, ya, dia underground. Either completely underground ataupun partially underground. So bila it is located underground, water forces daripada atas, daripada. So kita kena pastikan the walls and the floors of the basement are waterproof. Yeah, we do not want water to penetrate ataupun masuk daripada dinding, masuk daripada lantai. Kenapa? Kalau water boleh penetrate, lama-lama lantai dengan dinding akan crack. Yeah, so basement, another important element of basement is the waterproofing of the basement's floor and wall, ya. Yeah? So basically inilah benda-benda yang akan belajar dalam topik basement. Kemudian the final topic, ya, yeah, the final lecture for this course would be on surface, subsurface water drainage and pipe works. Yang ini very simple because this one is the same with what you learn in building services 1. Ya, yeah? So saya yang ajar you building services 1, nah, you tak boleh cakap saya apa topik ni belum belajar. This is exactly the same. You akan belajar water reticulation, you akan belajar drainage system, you akan belajar sewerage system, semua di dalam topik yang nombor 6 ni. Yeah, so in here, you will learn how water is being treated, tapi tak sedetail lah macam you belajar dalam building services 1 tu. Yeah. Then you akan belajar on the water drainage. So you will again come across the combined system, partially separated system and totally separated system. Then you will look at how sewerage is being treated. Yeah. So basically this is what you will learn in this topic lah. Yeah. So selalunya topik ni saya akan ajar dalam 1 week saja because it is not that lengthy, ya. Yeah? And then minggu 13 ni, kalau kata surface subsurface water drainage sempat habis minggu 12, minggu 13 you will have your presentation, ya, yeah? Presentation of your assignment. Kemudian selepas conclude everything, minggu ke-14 adalah test yang kedua. Test 2 will only cover topik daripada deep foundation sampai bawah. Ya, so maksudnya topik-topik yang dah masuk test pertama, dia tak akan masuk lagi test yang kedua. Ya, so test 2, deep foundation, basement dan juga surface water drainage and pipe works. Ya, so this is test 2. Ya. So tentatively test 2 adalah minggu 14. So after test 2, because we do not have final exam, then kita akan conclude lah all the course punya requirement by minggu yang ke-14. Ya. So sebab tu saya cakap Constack 4 ni dia senang nak score because you senang je nak ulang kaji. Untuk tiga topik yang pertama, revise untuk test yang satu. Untuk test 2, dia just cover tiga topik yang seterusnya. Okay? Boleh? Boleh ke? Ada apa-apa soalan?
Tak ada.
Ada ya? Sekejap ya. Sekejap ya, give me 1 minute. Okay, so basically that is the course info lah ya, on 552. Again, like I mentioned, not too much to introduce. Yeah, basically just to give you a general ataupun a walkthrough lah ya, on what the course is all about. Yeah, so basically the important thing that you have to take note is number one is the assignment. Yeah, once the assignment is ready, I will hand it out to you and don't wait until the last minute ya, baru you nak buat assignment. Yeah, assignment buat awal-awal untuk especially untuk semester yang keempat ni ada banyak ya assignment yang akan happen concurrently. Project management one, eco, so ada banyak. And then on test, ya, test selalunya dia format dia dalam bentuk essay, ya. Kemudian maybe akan ada sedikit MCQ, but then sebelum you sit for the test, I will brief you dulu on the format, ya, and on apa nama tu, what we expect lah out of the student, ya. Untuk Constack, untuk bantu ya dari segi pemahaman, ya, because what we will learn in class adalah teori, so mungkin you will not be able to visualize ya apa yang you belajar. So we do have videos ya, accompanying videos that you can refer to. Katalah you belajar piling ya, so mungkin you nak imagine tu is very difficult. Selalunya kita akan bagi video on how it is done on site supaya you can see. Ya, kata saya cerita top down for example ya, mungkin you tak terfikir macam mana dia nak buat daripada atas, dia nak turun daripada atas baru dia nak apa, construct atas baru construct bawah. So kita akan ada video, some dalam bentuk animation, some dalam bentuk real project punya scenario, so that will help ya, to enhance you punya understanding from what you learn in class. Ya, again, untuk you punya level, degree level ya, it's not sufficient to just gain knowledge on class, dalam class ya, you dengar-dengar lecture, you faham, itu belum lagi. Ya, untuk standard degree level, you have to be able to apply. Ya, kata kita bagi scenario, you terus boleh tahu. Okay, katalah I give you a condition of the site, then you will need to explain ataupun suggest what type of excavation technique would be suitable. Ya, so for your level, sepatutnya dah boleh. Okay, tengok pada ciri-ciri site, ya, kemudian bandingkan dengan apa nama tu, criteria-criteria excavation technique for example, then you should be able to explain, yeah, suggest, yeah. So sebab tu soalan-soalan test dan juga assignment untuk Constack 4 dia lebih kepada application, yeah, not as straightforward, yeah, tapi lebih kepada application. Contoh kita bagi you scenario, suggest what type of pile is the most suitable ataupun explain what is the type of basement construction yang paling sesuai, yeah. So again, it's all about application, macam mana you apply knowledge you ke dalam real case scenario. Apa lagi saya nak cerita ni? Ada apa-apa yang you nak tanya? Hai Adam. Hai. Sebenarnya it would help ya, kalau boleh buat site visit, cuma itulah site visitnya kena plan awal ya. So kalau you all plan untuk buat site visit, we should apa nama tu, satu plan daripada awal, yang kedua kekangan dari segi budget. Kita tak sure sama ada faculty ataupun jabatan akan provide ke tidak ya. So I can help you find out, ataupun kalau you nak tahu lebih pasal site visit ni, you boleh bercakap dengan Sir Azli ataupun Sir Nashairi. Tapi sebelum contact diorang, saya tanya dululah kod lah dah bertukar orang person in charge-nya. Tapi selalunya untuk site visit ni, dia perlukan consensus daripada student yang pergi tu that you might need to bear the cost on your own. Ya, sebab kalau saya tak silap lah, kecuali it is part of the requirement di dalam course tu, dia punya course-course yang berkaitan tu mungkin faculty tak cover semua. It would help, definitely would help kalau ada site visit, tapi itulah ada kekangan-kekangan untuk pergi. Ya, tapi saya akan try untuk, sebab untuk semester ni pun ada ramai yang mengajar subjek ni. Kalau ada maybe boleh gabung site visit tu, dekat-dekat pun tak apa, nanti I'll get back to you on that. Okay? Okay, cuma selalunya susah sebab dari segi kos tu. Dari segi kos nak menampung untuk pergi site visit tu. Kalau faculty provide, then it's easy. Yeah? Provide at least transportation ke, yeah? Tapi kalau tak, then semua tu kena ditanggung sendirilah oleh student. Yeah? So, sebab tu kalau site visit normally, student kalau dia dah ada plan nak pergi, kadang-kadang dia akan set the whole semester tu untuk dia plan saja. Contohlah sekarang you part 4 kan, you boleh plan untuk pergi part 5 punya subjek pula macam tu. So kalau macam sekarang ni saya tak sure sempat ke tidak untuk kita plan. But then we can try, yeah? We can try untuk arrange. Cuma saya tak janjilah mudah ke tidak untuk pergi tu. Ya? Yeah? Okay, ada soalan lain? Jadi kalau tak ada soalan, saya akan proceed dengan attendance, ya. Yeah. Sekejap, let me check dulu where is the attendance. Let's see. Okay, Aida Hazira.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Aina Nabila.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Ashraf Idris.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Farish Iskandar. Farish Iskandar ada ke? Kita ada Hilwina Az-Zahra.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Irdina Fatia.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Izzatul Fazlina.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Muhammad Rafar.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Muhammad Adam. Ada tadi Adam. Okay. Muhammad Alif Haikal.
Ada, ada.
Okay. Muhammad Darwish.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Nick Natasha.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Nick Nurdini Amani.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Nur Adriana.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Nur Ain Izati.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Nur Afrina Sofia.
Ada, madam.
Right. Nur Aida Liana.
Ada, madam.
Okay. Nur Ain Najibah. Nur Ain Najibah ada ke? Nur Ain Najibah. Okay, Nur Ain Najibah tak ada. Nur Fagira?
Ada, madam.
Okay, Nur Fagira is here. Nur Shazlin Shafiqah?
Ada, madam.
Okay, Nurin Wadiha?
Ada, madam.
Okay, Nurin is here. Mana dah? Nur Sabrina Alia.
Ada, madam.
Okay, Sabrina ada. Nurul Rauza?
Ada, madam.
Nurul Rauza ke Nurul Rauda ni? Rauza.
Rauza.
Rauza. Okay, Nurul Rauza. Nurul Shamira?
Ada, madam.
Okay, Shamira is here. Siti Aisyah Kamarudin? Siti Aisyah Kamarudin tak ada, ya? Okay, dan lastly Wan Nur Akila.
Saya, madam.
Okay, alright. So ada 3 absentees, 26. Siapa yang Farish Iskandar ada? Kalau ikut kan,
madam.
Ya. Yeah.
Saya ada. Aina Najibah.
What happened to you, Aina Najibah?
Tadi pergi toilet.
Okay, alright. So, I Najib Aisyah. So, ada dua orang je tak datang. Okay, again, you have been with me. Saya dah pernah ajar kelas you all. So, you know how I teach. Yeah? Kalau tak dapat datang, any emergencies ataupun sakit ke, inform me before class. Yeah? Inform sebelum kelas, saya kata tak datang. Because, walaupun subjek ni tak ada final exam, ya, yeah? Kalau untuk subjek yang ada final exam, kalau you tak datang, kita, apa, you tak dapat duduk untuk final exam. Ya? Yeah? Tapi, kalau untuk subjek macam ni yang tak ada final exam, you will still be penalized. Ya? Kata kalau attendance you tak cukup, ya? Asyik tak datang, dah 3-4 kali tak datang, ya? You punya markah akan dikurangkan, ya? Markah daripada assignment. Ya? So because apa nama tu, kita nak pastikan student ni dia tak take the classes for granted just because you do not have final exam. Ya? So if you couldn't come to class, any emergency, any apa medical ataupun health condition, just let me know prior. Okay? Boleh?
Boleh, madam.
Boleh, madam.
Tadi saya nampak Farish Iskandar. Farish Iskandar, are you here?
Yes, madam.
What happened to you, Farish? Baru masuk?
Saya baru bangun, madam. Sorry, madam.
Baru bangun? Kelas dah habis dah, Farish? Saya dah panggil attendance dah pun. So, macam mana ni? Saya patut kira you hadir ke tak ni?
Tak tahulah.
You baru bangun. Kelas dah habis dah, Farish? Nanti next time jangan lambat ya. Nanti tak fair pada kawan-kawan yang lain yang datang daripada pukul berapa kita start tadi? 11 lebih. 11.35 ya.
Okay madam, sorry madam.
Okay, alright. So if you do not have any further question, we will start our lecture next week ya, on topic yang pertama. Again, check your future. Kalau saya dah nota dah ready dalam your future, saya akan inform, tapi saya akan send juga nota daripada WhatsApp ya, so you can be get ready lah sebelum kelas ya. Okay, so kalau tak ada apa-apa soalan, I think that would be all for this week. Let us close the session with Tasbih Kafarah and Surah Al-Nas. Okay, I will see you all again next week at 11 a.m. insyaAllah. Thank you everyone.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
You're welcome.